The error was when we were trying to create a asset master, system was giving us the error that there is some inconsistency in our chart of depreciation related to depreciation area 03. Okay, so let me show you how exactly we solved that error, and now we are not getting that error anymore. Okay, so if you remember, it was asking us to check this table T093B. Okay, and in this one, if I provide my company code, which is SF01, and click on online, see, currently it is showing closed fiscal year as 2018. Okay, but the problem was, before when we were getting the error, at that time this closed fiscal years were blank. Okay, so system was not able to show us any value here. Now normally in SAP ECC, whenever we create a new chart of depreciation based on currently which year we are in, okay, so for example we are in 2018 in terms of April to March. Okay, I'm talking about the financial year. So financial year, currently we have 2018, due to which whenever we create a chart of depreciation, system automatically updates the value as the previous fiscal year. So normally this should have been automatically filled with 2017, okay, by default. But in this system, maybe because of some issue with some of the SAP nodes, or maybe if you are also facing the same issue when you are working on the client system, what you need to do is you just need to carry out the fiscal year change program. Normal, what you do in SAP ECC, right? So in order to carry out the fiscal year change program, we normally use this transaction AJAB, right? So you go to accounting, in accounting you go for financial accounting, fixed assets, periodic processing, fiscal year change, sorry, not this, year in closing, AJAB. You need to execute this. You need to tell the system that which fiscal year is already closed for this company code. Okay, so now once I updated this to 2018, actually even I have done wrong, I should have done 2017, but it's okay, because now whatever postings we have to do in 2019, but that is fine. Okay, so if I provided year 2017, I would be able to post the transactions in 2018. But now since 2018 is closed, only thing I need to be careful is whatever transactions I'll be posting, I have to post in 2019. Okay, so that was the only issue which has unnecessarily occupied 2 or 3 days from us. Okay, but now I hope you understood. This is not the normal case. In 1709 also we never faced this issue where this was blank. Okay, but if this is blank, I told you, very straightforward, go to transaction AJAB, execute the fiscal year change for your previous year. Okay, so I have done the mistake because I have closed 2018, because I was thinking that we are using K4, but actually we are using V3 fiscal year, which is from April to March. Okay, any question on this now? Have you understood how I solved this error? Okay, so now since this error is solved, if I now go to transaction AS01, the error that we were getting is no more valid, and if I press enter, system is allowing me to go further and create the asset master. But before I go into the asset master creation, because there are already 4 to 5 days since we have done the configuration, I will quickly give you the overview of whatever we have done in the chart of depreciation till now from the asset accounting perspective. So in SPRO, within asset accounting, first of all, we created the chart of depreciation. Let me show you which chart of depreciation we created. We created the chart of depreciation. We created SF01 earlier, but since I was facing the issue, I changed it to SF02. So currently SF02 is assigned to our company code. Okay, so if I go to SF02, you can see there are 3 depreciation areas. I told you in SAP ECC, only 1 depreciation area was mandatory if you are using asset accounting. So even if you have multiple ledgers, multiple currencies, only 1 depreciation area was sufficient. But in S4 HANA, For each and every standard non-leading ledger that you have created in your company code, you had to create a depreciation area for that. And that is the reason we created the depreciation area for IFRS separately. Not only for the ledgers, even if you are using any parallel currency, so even for that parallel currency also, you have to create a separate depreciation area. That is the reason we created three depreciation areas, out of which two are posting in real time and one is not posting at all. It is only used for the reporting purpose. So parallel currency depreciation areas, normally they don't post anything. They are taking the values from 0, 1, but only thing is they are performing the currency conversion. That's it. Okay. Now these two depreciation areas, 0, 1 and 0, 2, which is for two different ledgers, one for 0L and second for IF, they are posting in real time. This kind of setting was not allowed in SAP ECC. If you are using SAP ECC system, you cannot post two depreciation areas in real time. Only one depreciation area, most commonly 0, 1, was only allowed to post in real time. All other depreciation areas were always dependent on 0, 1 to pick its value. Okay, so the reason why we created three depreciation areas is because we have two ledgers and one parallel currency. Okay, there is in SAP ECC, because it was not possible to post two depreciation areas in the real time, that is the reason we were carrying out the periodic activity. And in order to carry out the periodic activity, we were using delta depreciation areas or derived depreciation areas, which are not supported in S/4HANA. We don't need delta depreciation area or derived depreciation area anymore, because each and every accounting principle can post in real time. Okay, so whatever I'm telling you, this is very important from the interview's perspective, although in the exams they are not very important, but in the interview they are definitely going to ask you what are the new things in new asset accounting. So you have to explain this, that in ECC we were only allowed to post one depreciation area in real time, and if you want to post second depreciation area, for that we have to create a derived depreciation area. And for making the postings, those postings were only possible as a periodic activity. We were using transaction ABST to make the periodic postings. But in S/4HANA, there is no need to create a delta depreciation area, because each depreciation area is independent and post on their own. And that is the reason there is no question of delta depreciation area and there is no question of periodic activities. Okay, so we created this chart of depreciation and then we assigned this chart of depreciation to our company code. Okay, so if I go for company code SF01, you can see it is assigned to chart of depreciation SF02. Okay, and the next thing, if you remember, I told you in general valuation there are some settings which you need to mandatorily perform. So just go to depreciation areas. First one is specify transfer of APC values. In this step, you are telling the system the values will come from where, whether these depreciation areas will pick their own values or these values will come manually. Okay, so you can see depreciation area 01 and 02, they are picking the values automatically. Okay, so they are not dependent on any other depreciation area. But depreciation area 03 is not posting anything, it is just picking the values from 01 and it is just performing the conversion. So this can be INR, this can be Euro. So values will be picked in INR, but it will be converted to Euro and then it will be shown as it is in 03. So this is for APC. Similarly, you have specified transfer of depreciation terms. So here also the same settings. By default, if you create any new depreciation area, it will go and pick the values from 01. But if you remember in the last session, I told you how to make this as 00. You cannot write 00 here. If you try 00, system will throw error. Okay, this error, T093 error. So what you need to do is you need to remove this and you just need to press enter. blank and enter, it will automatically pick 00. But in our case, it is dependent, so I'm keeping it as 01.
Gaurav.
Yes.
What does the term APC mean, Gaurav?
APC is acquisition, procurement, capitalization. So which means the asset procurement cost.
Okay.
See, there are two kind of transactions that you will be doing. APC is whenever you are buying, whenever you are selling, whenever you are capitalizing, those transactions. And second is posting the depreciation, which is a periodic activity. So for APC and for depreciation, there are two settings, different settings.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm not changing anything here. And then the last thing was this currencies. So if you are creating the depreciation area for parallel currencies, you have to set this to configurations. So define depreciation area for foreign currency. You will go to your company code here, depreciation area and currency. Here you will be specifying what is your parallel currency. So in our case, we created the parallel currency as 30 group currency, and group currency is also INR. But if it is any other currency, you will specify same currency, whatever you have maintained as your group currency. Okay, here also, in the next one also, you will be specifying which is the currency type. So we are using the hard currency. Sorry, we are using the group currency 30. Okay, so this is the configuration that we have done, and then we were trying to create an asset. And we were getting that error, which will not come now. So let's try to create an asset. So I'll go to transaction AS01. Just give me a minute. Sorry. So now let's create an asset. So in transaction AS01, if you remember, we activated this asset class for our chart of depreciation. Okay, so let me show you. So normally, if you go to this configuration of asset accounting, this is the configuration, determine depreciation areas in the asset class. Okay, here, these are the different asset classes. Now, these are not relevant to any particular chart of depreciation. These are just created at the client level. But whatever asset class you need to use, you have to select that asset class. You have to go into the depreciation areas, and you have to specify whether these depreciation areas are active for this asset class or not. Okay, so this one we activated, right? But if you go to any other, let's say if I go to maybe buildings and go to depreciation areas, see, by default, these are deactivated. So you need to activate them in order to get displayed in the asset master. Okay, so let's again go to AS01. I'm just pressing enter. So now that error is not coming, and we can proceed to create an asset. So let's say this is our director car, since this is our vehicle. So I'm just providing this description as director car. Okay, you can maintain whatever fields you want. There are no changes in the fields. Whatever fields you're able to see in ECC, those things are coming here. So just press enter. It will take you to the next one, or you can just click on the time dependent. Again, here also, whatever objects you want to mention, you want to specify the business area, you want to mention the cost center. So let's mention the cost center, because whatever cost center you will mention here, that cost center will be posted in case of depreciation. So whenever you are posting the depreciation, it is your expense. And if you want to show where exactly this expense is going, in which cost center, you are specifying it here in the asset master. Okay, you can skip this assignment and all. This is optional. So even in ECC, you have the same things. If you want to maintain, you can maintain. Otherwise, just go to the depreciation areas. Okay, again, there is no change here. You can see this useful life and all we maintained when we configured. So system is assuming the useful life is 5 years. But let's say due to some reason, if you want to change the useful life to 4 years instead of 5. So for book depreciation, which means according to India GAAP, the useful life is 5 years. But according to IFRS, the useful life is 4 years. Okay, so just press enter and save this. Now this is the opening date of starting the depreciation. So depreciation calculation start date. Normally, this is picked automatically once you acquire the asset. So once you capitalize the asset, system will automatically determine the depreciation start date, but it can be changed. So normally, we don't change this. So let's click on save. So our asset number 3002 has been created. Okay, so as of now, we just created the asset. Now, if you want to buy this asset, if you want to purchase this asset, there are two options. One is if you want to buy via our MM cycle, which means if you want to create a PO and then acquire the asset, that is also possible without any change how you were doing in SAP ECC. But PO process and all is same. But when it comes to accounting, there is a difference. And that is the reason I will just show you how to purchase the asset using a normal FI transaction, that is F-90. So I'll go to accounting, close this general ledger accounting in fixed assets, postings, acquisitions, external acquisition, and F-90 transaction. Okay, which is again the common transaction. Just double click on this. Now you will realize the difference. So you have to specify the document date, posting date. Now definitely I need to have this posting date in the next year. So document date, let's say, is 01/04/2019. Company code, again, posting date is 01/04/2019. Now, can you tell me one thing here? In SAP ECC, whenever you are trying to buy the asset, whenever you are using transaction F-90, what document type is populated automatically? Is it KR? What is the standard document type for?
I think AA, right? I don't think so. KR will populate.
Yeah, it is AA, right? In ECC?
Yes. Yeah.
In ECC, whenever we buy any asset or whenever we sell any asset, normally the standard document type for all asset related acquisitions is AA, but here it is showing you KR. Okay, we will discuss why it is showing you KR, because there is a big difference here. So what you normally provide in this screen, you are crediting your vendor, which means you are booking the invoice of the vendor and you are telling the system which vendor is providing you this asset. Okay, so I think we already created some vendors. Yeah, so we can use any of this vendor. I'm using this 131. Just press enter. Don't worry about this. Just click on enter. Again, enter. Yeah, so for document type KR, an entry is required field in the reference. So we need to specify some reference. So let's say test one and press enter once again. Okay, and here we need to specify the amount at what price we are buying this asset. So I'll specify as, let's say, 10,000. Okay, or maybe this is 5 years, right? Yeah, 10,000 is okay. Baseline date is the date based on which the system will determine the due date of this invoice. Okay, and you need to specify the posting key here. Can anyone tell me what is the posting key that we normally use for asset purchase, asset debit?
7075.
70 for acquisition and 75 for retirement, right? And we need to specify which asset are we debiting here. So just press F4. So we have created these two assets. I created this one earlier one to test, but this one we just now created. So let's continue on this. Okay, and do we need to provide the transaction type? If yes, what are the transaction type that we provide? 100, right? So whenever we purchase any asset, we specify the transaction type as 100. Perfect, same thing, just press enter. Now you will get this error. Technical clearing account is not maintained for chart of account SF01. Is this a common error in ECC? Is there anything called as technical clearing account in SAP ECC? Definitely not. In SAP ECC, there is no concept of technical clearing account. Okay, this is a new concept which is only applicable in SAP Simple Finance or SAP S/4HANA Finance. Okay, what does it mean? It means we need to create a technical clearing account first, and which is a GL account. We have to create a technical clearing account as a GL account, and the same GL account we have to assign in the configuration. Let me show you how to do that. So first, we need to create a technical clearing account. So I'll go to transaction FS00. Okay, so my assets are starting from 200. So this one, let's say, is 201. Okay, for company code SF01, I'm creating new. GL account type would be balance sheet. Account group also would be balance sheet. So this is technical clearing account. So technical clearing account. Okay, let's go to the control data. I don't remember exactly, but I think it has to be reconciliation account for account type assets. Let's try this. Otherwise, if it is not allowing, we have to remove this indicator. Let's go to create bank interest tab. In the field status group, you have to specify the same field status group that you assign to your asset accounts. So for asset accounts, we normally use G007. Okay, just try to save this. This is saved. So we created a technical clearing account, but creation is not enough, right? It is just created, but it is not assigned to our company code. Okay, so for that, you have to go for SPRO, IMG within asset accounting, integration with GA general ledger account. So integration with general ledger accounting, and there is a new folder here. Okay, this folder you will not find in SAP ECC. Technical clearing account for integrated asset acquisition. Okay, so click on this. Define the technical clearing account for integrated asset acquisition. Just specify go to here, and here you can see based on the chart of account, we have to specify the technical clearing account. So let's click on new entry. Chart of account is SF01, and technical clearing account that we just created was 201. Right? Just press enter and click on save. Okay, now let's go back again and try to press enter there in our transaction.
But
So
sir,
it
why we need to create technical clearing account?
yes, I'm coming to it, Akash, because when you see the posting, then you will understand why we have created that. Okay, so I think we need to come out and try this once again. So F-90. Okay, 31. We have to provide the vendor, which is 131. Press enter. Specify the reference amount 70. This asset transaction type 100 and press enter. Okay, so now that error is gone, because system has determined the technical clearing account. You can see here, this 201 technical clearing account has been determined by the system. Okay, you have to specify the amount once again. So whatever amount you specified earlier, this will be specified again here also. So now the posting seems to be done. Let's simulate this and see how it is appearing. So if I go for more document and simulate. Okay, so first of all, it is throwing error, which is a common error. You will also get an ECC. We are still not specified any accounts. We are not maintained the account determination for asset accounting. Okay, so what should we do? In order to maintain that, we will go to, let me come out of this AO90, right? AO90 is a transaction to assign the GL accounts, this particular config. So I have to go for assign GL accounts. For chart of account SF01, account determination, I have to check what account determination is assigned to asset class 3100. Anyone who has no experience into SAP asset accounting, are you aware of this terminologies AO90 and all, everyone? Or you want me to explain that also? Please let me know if anyone is new to asset accounting completely. I don't have any problem. It will not take much time, but I can explain that. Okay, so in asset accounting.
Yeah, please explain, Gaurav.
Okay. See, in asset accounting, your GL accounts are based on the account determination. Okay. So in order to determine the GL accounts, if you go to the asset class, let me show you the asset class general valuation. No, just a minute. Asset classes are available there. Yeah, in the organization structure, you have this asset classes. And when you create the asset class, there are two, three things that you specify. Okay, let me show you what are those things. So currently we are using this asset class 3100. If I double click on this, you can see this 3100 asset class is assigned to 31,000 account determination. Okay, now based on this account determination, 31,000, we will go to this transaction AO90, okay, which is account determination transaction, and we will go with this particular account determination. And here there are different GLs which we need to maintain. We need to tell the system what will happen in case of depreciation posting, what will happen in case of APC posting, and what will happen in case of special reserve. So normally we don't maintain this, but this balance sheet account and depreciation account we have to maintain for a particular account determination. Okay, so if I go for this balance sheet accounts, you can see there are two depreciation areas which are posting in real time. And that is the reason system is asking you the accounts for book depreciation also and IFRS also. Okay, so since we are using ledger based approach, right? Currently we are using ledger based approach. So we don't have any problem even if the GL accounts are same in IFRS and book depreciation, because if you are using account based approach, definitely we need different GL accounts. But in case of ledger based approach, we can assign same GL accounts to both the depreciation areas. So if I go to this book depreciation, you can see we are still not provided any GL account, and that is the reason we are getting this error. What is this error? This error is account is not defined for depreciation area 01 for balance sheet account APC, which is nothing but this account, balance sheet account APC. So whenever we are posting anything in this asset class 3100, which GL account should be debited, that we have to specify here. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to first create a GL account. Let's create a GL account. I'll go to transaction FS00. So this is, let's say, 202, which is again one of the asset. Just click on new balance sheet account. Account group is also going to be balance sheet, and this is going to be the fixed assets or FA for vehicles. Okay, so all the debit postings will go to this GL account whenever anyone is buying any vehicles, any acquisition for the vehicles. So this would be again the reconciliation account for account type asset, and this one also would be G007 for asset accounts. Just click on save. So this GL account has been created, which we can now assign to our account determination screen. Okay, so once this is done, now that error will not come. It will automatically determine that account. Okay, so based on the scenarios that we'll be executing, we will also run one scenario on acquisition, retirement, asset sales, and all. So we need to specify all these GL accounts. Okay, so as of now is okay because we are just doing the acquisition. So this one is fine, but when we will talk about the scenarios, we also will need to maintain all these GL accounts. So this is AO90 screen, which allows you to maintain the different GLs based on different scenarios in this account determination screen. Okay, so now if I go back again to our invoice, let's see if I press enter, it goes away or we need to come completely out of the screen. So you can see, okay, before I tell you about this, can you tell me what is the normal accounting entry when you perform the asset acquisition? What is the normal accounting entry in ECC? Anyone? Whenever I'm purchasing the asset, what is the accounting entry with vendor? What would be debited? What would be credited?
Asset account will be debited and vendor will be credited.
Asset account debit and vendor will be credited. Okay, this is a normal posting. Let's see what is happening here. So this is also correct. Vendor is getting credited and asset is getting debited. But if you see here, is this the asset account? 201. This is a technical clearing account, right? Then where exactly the asset is coming into the picture? Where is 202, which we created just now? Okay, so in order to see that, just click on this asset accounting and it will give you the complete picture. Okay, still I think it is asking us for, just give me a minute, document. Let me do this simulation once again and click on asset accounting. No, let's go back and come to this screen once again. So F-90, which is acquisition with vendor. Okay, we have to provide the reference, the vendor number is enter. Amount, posting key would be 70. Here we'll specify our asset with the transaction type 100, press another enter. Here you have to specify the amount and now more document and simulate. So, oh, it is still showing this error. Yeah, sorry. This is error for 02 area. We only specified the GL account for 01. So let's go to, where is that? Yes. Account determination 3100 balance sheet account, but this time we need to provide for 2. I'll assign the same GL because we are using ledger based approach. So just click on save. Let's try if we are able to simulate this now. Okay, now it is working. So just click on asset accounting. Here you will get the complete picture, what is happening in the background. So earlier in SAP ECC, this was the only posting and there was only one document created. So let me write it here. In ECC, only one document is posted. Okay. With document type AA. And this was the posting. Now what is happening in SAP S/4HANA is in S4, there will be one document called as operational document. Okay, please remember this. This is very important question again from the interview perspective. So there will be one document called as operational document with document type KR. Okay, what would be the accounting entry? Instead of asset debit, this would be technical clearing account debit. So technical clearing account debit, vendor credit. So vendor is getting credited in the same this one. So there is no change in the vendor line item. But apart from one operational document, there will be multiple valuation specific documents. What do you mean by valuation specific documents? Valuation specific documents means how many accounting principles you have, that much number of documents will be created. Okay, so how many valuation specific, how many accounting principles we are following? Currently, we are following two. So two accounting principles. One is India GAAP, or maybe let's write the ledger 0L and IF. So there will be two documents created, one for 0L and second for IF. So for 0L, what would be the posting? This will be document type AA. The posting would be actual asset account, asset getting debited, and technical clearing account is getting credited. So in short, this technical clearing is only used for the clearing purpose. Okay, so here it is debit, here it is credit in the same posting. Okay, so at any point of time, if you go and see the balance in the technical clearing account, this will be always zero, right? Same thing, if you go to ledger IF, again, there will be another document type AA, same document type, and the posting will be again the same. Okay, the only difference would be this posting will be done in ledger IF. This posting will be done in the ledger 0L. So in short, in SAP S/4HANA, see, in ECC, there was only one document, irrespective of how many ledgers you have. Because even if you have multiple ledgers, all the ledgers are dependent on 0/1. So at the time of document posting, there was only one ledger which was having the values. That is the reason there was only one document getting created. But in SAP S/4, since multiple depreciation areas can post in real time, so the system is dividing the document into two parts. First one is an operational document, which is common for all the accounting principles. Vendor will be credited in both 0L as well as IFRS. Okay, but asset part will be taken separately, valuation specific. And that is the reason we need a technical clearing account, which will be used to clear the balances in both the accounting principles. Okay, so if somebody asks you how many documents are created when you purchase the asset in S/4HANA, it would be one operational document and the valuation specific documents will be created with the same number that you have the number of ledgers. So how many ledgers are posting in real time, that much number of documents will be created in the valuation specific posting. Okay, let me show you how it will look like in the system now. So if you see this, what is happening? Currently, we are looking at India GAAP accounting principle. So in India GAAP accounting principle, there are two documents. One is document type KR. If you see these lines, so document type, let me just try to, yeah. So document type KR is having two documents, sorry, two lines, vendor credit and technical clearing account debit. Okay. And then in 0L, you can see this is valuation specific document based on accounting principle. So in the valuation specific document, 201 is getting credited and 202 is getting debited. Okay, so at any point of time, 201 plus minus zero. Okay, this is just the internal posting it is doing. But otherwise, at any point of time, the technical clearing account balance will be always zero. Now, what if I want to see IFRS pictures? So I will go to for IFRS. Yes, I have to select it from here. So IFRS, and again, I can specify the currency. So I want to see the company code currency. See, same thing is happening in the IFRS also. So document type KR, which is a common document, which is posted in both 0L as well as IF, and then valuation specific document, which is only posted in IFRS, is again the same. Okay, but system is keeping two separate documents for two accounting principles, because they are posting in real time and they are completely independent of each other. You understood now what is technical clearing account, Akash? Why it is required? This is to support the real time postings.
Gaurav, yes. What is the business use, Gaurav? Means if you do like this?
No, see, earlier, again, as I told you, Varun, earlier, if you are using multiple accounting principles, let's say you are using India GAAP in real time and IFRS as these parallel reporting. So in that case, you were always dependent on India GAAP for your IFRS reporting. And that too, in the period end, you had to do a lot of period end activities to get the IFRS results. But now, since IFRS is also posting in real time, you are not dependent on 01, first thing. And second thing, you are getting your reports even for IFRS in real time. And you don't need to perform any period end activities. That is a benefit. And in order to achieve that, SAP has to create this multiple documents, because you are posting multiple documents in multiple accounting principles. And in order to segregate those, they have to use this technical clearing account in between.
Yes. Okay.
So the benefit is real-time report. You are getting real-time report in all the accounting principles, and you are avoiding the period end activities. So definitely everyone likes to see the reports without carrying out any further activities in the period end. So that is a benefit of this new asset accounting. It provides you real-time values in multiple accounting principles without the use of, or without any kind of period end activities required. Akash, is it clear?
Okay.
Now you know what is technical clearing account, why it is required?
Yes, yes.
Okay. This is a very important question when you are going for the interviews. They will definitely, if you specify in your CV that I have worked on new asset accounting, they will definitely ask you what is the change in the acquisition posting, what is the change in the procurement posting. And when you are saying technical clearing account, they will definitely ask you, what is the purpose of technical clearing account and all those things. So just remember this entire cycle and then you will be very confident to answer this question.
Gaurav, if we post from procurement side also, it happens like this only?
Same thing, yes. Whenever you are posting from the procurement, only thing is whatever accounting entries will come, that will come via PO. But the postings will be same, 70-75. Even in SAP ECC also, whenever you purchase any asset from MM, the posting key is 70 only, right? So same thing will happen. Only thing is it will flow via MM model.
Okay.
Yes, Ujay. Ujay, you unmuted yourself. Do you have any questions? Okay. Okay, so now, if you are okay with these postings, you will just click on, just come out of the simulation mode. And let's try to post this document. Now, again, this is a new thing that you will not find in SAP ECC. Okay. What it is saying is, system is not able to find the document number for Ledger IF. Okay, let me tell you first what is happening. So this document